I had to find the Karate Kid fans that were putting up the posters of Ralph Macchio. I was able to track down some members of the group responsible. To find them, I had to travel to San Francisco. The group wanted to be known only as the Macchio Family, and they cautiously agreed to let us interview them in disguise.
It got popular in Los Angeles, you know, the West Coast, there's stuff in Europe, there's minor stuff on the East Coast, and you know, people are starting to learn about it.
It's not about who started it, it's not about who's been in it the longest, it's not about who has put up the most posters. You know, if you know you're down, you're down.
Yeah.
You're into it, you're into it.
Postering, or wheat pasting, is the street art form whereby vandals illegally affix posters of an image all over the walls of a city.
Hey, if you put up a sticker, you're part of it, you know what I mean? Like, you're actually part of it. And, like, the thing is, like, you know, it's not about, like, who's in charge or any of this and that. It's just like, hey, you know, like, we're all together in this.
We don't want people really to know who does this. That's kind of the cool thing about it. It's like, oh, Ralph Macchio, it's everywhere. Who does it? No one knows.
The motive of the Macchio family is simple. To spread the image of the Karate Kid all over the world.
It really caught people's eye, and you really don't realize how much people actually just love the movie.
I've never heard a bad response from it. Ever.
Yeah.
Everyone seems to be into it.
Who doesn't like Ralph Macchio?
Right.
Especially who doesn't like the Karate Kid? It's like, you know,
Nazis.
I mean, for me, it's like, when I was a kid, it was just like, yeah, that was the shit. Karate Kid, I want to learn karate, want to defend myself, want to be like, you know, like, I totally identified with his character.
Yeah.
So when I post her now, I'm just like, I get that hype, and I'm just like, yeah, like, I feel like a little fucking kid again. I'm just like, yeah.
The kid from the lower class.
Yeah.
Raising up.
Yeah.
To beat the chump, yuppie white kid.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about.
I think Ralph Macchio is the ultimate symbol of the underdog. You know, it's the ultimate symbol of, like, someone who's got nothing going for him. You know, he's getting picked on, and he doesn't take shit.
The Macchio family allowed me to come with them on a postering mission to cover up a billboard.
You should come out and, like, be part of this. If you want to be part of it, then let's fucking do it.
They shared another objective of their campaign, a practice known as ad jamming.
Another thing that we should mention is ad jamming. You know, if there's a Coke ad or, you know, some, you know, an ad for anything, you know, we can poster over it and we can throw up a Ralph Macchio head and no one knows what it means. No one knows who does it. There's a huge mystery to it.
Yeah.
The whole commercialization of, like, America, the whole, you know, advertisements are thrown everywhere.
It's like all this shit's being, like, pumped into our heads, like, on a daily basis.
That's something that's beyond us.
We're the total fuck you to, like, you know.
You just get numb, you know, you just get numb after a while.
Yeah, totally.
If you have enough money, you can force people to see whatever you want them to see to buy your stuff or whatever sort of thing, your agenda you're trying to push. Why don't we, for free, force our agenda into the public subconscious? Like, we don't have any money, you know, we're not rich people, and you know, it's like, I have an agenda, I'm gonna force it in your subconscious. I don't have the money to pay for a billboard, so I'm just going to cover it up.
The Macchio family is always looking over their shoulder for authorities. Just a few months earlier, two of their members were caught and arrested. We tracked down one of them, who had since moved to London to escape the Macchio scene and pull his life back together.
We were down in LA on a freeway ramp, and we were going to put up this poster, and the cops just drove right up the on-ramp, and they arrested us. They took us in. They said, no, we've been looking for you for a long time.
There is a risk involved, and unfortunately,
That's the huge downside.
So there was a lot of attorney fees, there was bail.
There was a lot of pressure from law enforcement to stop doing it, and it could even get to the point where, you know, you think, like, you know, like, is it worth it? You know what I mean? Is it worth it to keep going out there? Is it worth it to keep taking the risk? Is it worth it to keep going to jail?
I wondered what Ralph Macchio would think about these guys.
I don't know. I hope his reaction would be good, because I love the movie. I think he's a cool guy. Like, I'd hope that he would appreciate it, you know, and try to understand that it's not like a mockery. It's not something that's funny, you know. It's not someone that's...
Oh, it's complete idolization.
Yeah, yeah. You know, it's like, I want to realize, like, the passion that we're putting behind this is, like I said, I want to turn Ralph Machio's face into like the Pepsi logo.
I couldn't imagine what he'd be feeling in that position, like, you know, if somebody was idolizing the fuck out of me, I don't know what the fuck to do, but...
I would expect him to think, like, what the hell is my face doing here?
I hope it kind of, like, freaks him out a little bit, though, because I think it would be kind of fun for me to be driving down a freeway and see, like, a massive poster in my face, and I'm like, what the fuck is that, like...
What is the Karate Kid doing on the freeway?
Their idolization went even further than just billboards. A few of the members had even had the image tattooed on their bodies.
For me, it symbolizes just like, I don't know, just the fun I've had with these guys going out and going fucking balls out and having the fucking time of my life and like that rush, just like everything that I feel like in that moment is just like, it's so intense and so unlike anything, like no drug can take you there. I got the tattoo because like, I'm down for that, and like, I love that feeling, and I don't want to let go of that. Like, I want to do it till the day I die.
It's like, you know, I've had a lot of great memories, so like, if I'm an old man, and you know, I have the Karate Kid tattoo, I'm gonna be like, that was a good time, you know, those were good times. At least I can look back, and it's kind of a symbolism for maybe if I change from now, I can look back and say like, hey, that's who I was. These were the times that I had. These were the friends that I had.
Although I found their methods of expression to be bizarre, I respected their commitment. And one thing was certain. The Karate Kid had a huge impact on these guys.
Like, my life was, like, fucking shitty. Had woman problems, everything. And, like, seriously, like, the only thing that took my mind off it for a long-ass time was the Machio. And, like, I just got so, like, wrapped up in it. And I fucking love it. Like, I don't know. It's just pure fun to me. Like, it makes me feel like... like, I'm fucking 5 years old, seeing the Karate Kid for the first time. Like, that excitement.
It's almost like going into battle, you know? Ralph Macchio was like, he was the flag, and we were, like, conquering spots, you know? Just as soon as you put the poster up there, it's yours, you know? It's your spot.
And now, it was time for me to go into battle.